change. Bueno, sí.
Welcome to the Soccer Academy. I'm your host, Antonio Suave, and we are coming to you from the great country of Syria in the Middle East. Stay tuned because we'll be back with some great soccer action.
The country of Syria is one of the oldest and most amazing places on the planet. It is considered to be at the very source of Western civilization and is often referred to as the cradle of civilization. It has a rich and bountiful culture and heritage that dates back over 6,000 years.
Stay tuned. We'll be right back with more of the Soccer Academy. Welcome back to Damascus, Syria, and more of the Soccer Academy.
While in Damascus, we were invited to train with the Syrian professional team, Al-Jaish. The Al-Jaish Soccer Club plays in the Syrian Premier Division. They have some extraordinary training techniques that consist of a variety of multifaceted and multidimensional drills. And these drills often revolve around multitasking. Al-Jaish trains at the beautiful National Military Training Complex on the outskirts of Damascus. Their general manager, Mr. Hassan, is one of the best respected figures in all of Syrian soccer. Al-Jaish also has one of the youngest pro players in the Middle East. He's just 18 years old. Even as a professional player, it's really important to have fun when you play. We're in the Umayyad Square. It's home of Umayyad Palace, and I'm here with my good friend Basil in Old Damascus in Syria. Basil, thanks for being with us.
You're most
welcome. So tell me a little bit about what's going on here. What's behind us?
Now, behind us is the former Temple of Jupiter in
the Roman former days. Temple of Jupiter?
Yes, in the
wow,
Roman
that's
days.
That's pretty cool.
It was later on converted to be a Christian church, and then later on a Muslim mosque.
Wow.
But what is interesting about this place is that Muslims and Christians used to pray here some of the time. So they had the very first experience of friendship between Muslims and Christians.
So it was the Temple of Jupiter, then it
yes.
was a Christian church, then it's a mosque, and
yes.
now it's a mosque.
Yes.
But it first started as a planetary system.
Yes.
All right, good. All right, so what are we going to do now? We're going to walk to the bazaar, and we're going to go see some of the shops.
Okay.
All right, let's do it.
There we go.
What do we have here? What are these kids doing?
These are two magnets.
They're okay. two magnets, and what
so,
do they do?
So when you throw them up, they'll attract and subtract each other.
Can you ask him to demonstrate? Wow, that's pretty cool. So they sell these. How much do they sell these for?
$25. بعرف قديش حقها. It's about 25.
About 25 cents.
Yeah. He told me that's 75.
75 for you. All right, thanks. Here you've got sort of remnants of the Quran, right? Or surahs of the Quran, or saying of the Quran?
Just the Almighty name Allah.
Just the Almighty name Allah. That's pretty big to put around your neck. So you, people actually wear that thing?
Well, they wear it actually for occasions rather than every day's wear, because it's right. A little bit heavy on the neck.
Right, but just religious, no rapology going on there. Basil, we're here at Bakdash, one of the oldest ice cream places
Yes. In
Damascus.
Yes.
So what goes on over here? I mean, they make ice cream by hand.
Now, they're making ice cream by hand the same way it has been done before. This shop is since 1895.
Since 1895, this shop alone.
Yes.
But basically, they're using old-style techniques to make ice cream, right?
Yes.
The basic question, the essential question is, can I find soccer gear here?
Soccer gear?
Yeah, can I find stuff to wear for soccer?
Of course you can.
Oh, that's important.
With
that's
all
very
this
important.
Club, you've got a lot of options.
So all the kids from around the world, they can come here to Old Damascus and they can buy soccer stuff.
Indeed.
That's what we're interested in. Welcome back to the Soccer Academy. We got more great soccer action for you. Marhaba! We are here at the Tishrin Stadium, one of the greatest youth national team stadiums in the country of Syria. And I have the distinct privilege of having three under 17 national team players with me. I have Hussam, Khalid, and Ahmad.
Ana Hussam Hamoud.
Ana Khalid Bijay.
Ana Ahmad Saleh.
All right. What we're going to do now is we're going to go through some drills and we're going to have our three players demonstrate them as well. The first thing we're going to do is work on using the bottom of our feet. So we're going to go back and forth, guiding the ball along gently with the bottom of our feet. Okay? So let's do the first drill. The first drill is we're going to simply advance the ball with the bottom of our feet forward and coming backward with it. Okay? So basically, we're dancing with the ball, head up, head down, look around the field, all right, and pass it off. All right, go ahead. And as you can see, the concentration and focus, there's a great deal of rhythm. He looks up, he looks down, looks all around the field. Excellent. All right, the next drill. All right. And here we go. Back, pulling the ball over. Excellent. Every step is a touch on the ball. Keep focus. And you want to make sure to not just use the cleats of your shoe. You want to drag the ball along. Drag the ball along. So hit it at the midpoint of your shoe and drag it along. Also remember rhythm. Rhythm is fundamentally important. Head up, head down. And remember, whatever we do with the right, we do with the left. Every step is a touch on the ball. Always know where your teammates are. And then we want to get creative. We want to get a bit creative. Once again, when we're practicing these drills, don't be afraid to be creative. All right, so as we're looking around, there are little touches on the ball, and sometimes we can go back and forth, come down, all right, and little touches. Now we're gonna do little touches between the feet. All right, again, focus is fundamentally important. Right? And then test yourself by going faster and faster. Focus and stay light on your feet. Always stay light on your feet. Looking up, looking down. We're here with two of the best goalkeepers in the country of Syria, and they play for the under 17 national team. That's Nur and Allah. Not to be confused with Allah, which means God. So you gotta be very careful when you pronounce that, okay? What they're gonna demonstrate for us today is catching the ball. Very simple. It's a fundamental technique, but what you do is you keep your hands closed, you create a web, and you catch the ball, and you gotta make sure that these hands are not too wide. All right, it's fundamental, it's basic, but that's how we start. There we go, just tossing the ball back and forth. Keep the web, get in front of the ball. And that's what they wanna do, just get in front of the ball, position yourself, always create the web. So as you'll notice, the hands go up before the ball gets there, and they create a web so that the ball doesn't go through. That's all we have to say from Tishreen Stadium.
Ahlan bikum fi akademiyat kurat qadam. Ahlan bikum fi
akademiyat. Good, again.
Ahlan bikum fi akademiyat kurat qadam.
We're now in the ancient city of Malula, and this place is fantastic. And we're in front of one of the oldest churches in the world, St. Sergius and Bacchus.
So we are here.
This is really something fantastic. How old is this church, Father Confessor?
The 4th century, in fact.
Fourth century?
4th century, yes. Built on the ruins of the Temple of Apollo of the 3rd century before Christ.
So we're talking about 1600 years ago.
Yeah.
So tell us a little bit about this rock and these walls. Are these originals?
Is this
from 1600 years ago?
Of course. The lower parts in the church must be of the 4th century. Mm-hmm. But the vault must be later.
Okay.
It must be later. In fact, maybe the church had another roof before the vault, and then they added the vault maybe in the 7th, 8th century when the theology began to be expressed in the architecture. Because the vault is an octagon, exact octagon.
Wow.
We have here in this middle part of the iconostasis all these icons, the crucifixion, the apostles, the two saints, Sergius and Bacchus, the Christ, and the Virgin Mary. All these icons are painted by Michael of Crete in 1813 using the brocades because he used to live in Damascus.
Father Tufek, thank you once again. You've been so kind. Thank you for having us here as your guest in Malula.
You're welcome, and I'm very happy to see you here.
Well, maybe we can continue to spread peace through soccer and through better understanding.
Of course.
Thank you,
Father. Thank you. Bye-bye.
We're here in the old city of Damascus, and it is something absolutely extraordinary. There are buildings here dating back over 6,000 years, if you can believe it. And I have the special privilege to be sitting with the Director of Press and Information for Syrian Radio and Television. That's Miss Reem Haddad.
Thank you, Antonio. It's a pleasure to have you.
It's great to be here. Tell us a little bit about Damascus and some of this history.
Well, Damascus is Damascus. It's the oldest continuously inhabited city in the world. It's like got layers of history. And what's very beautiful about Damascus is the way that the old and the new intermingle together and live side by side as if it's totally normal and natural. And you can see this also with the people. You have the Christians and the Muslims and all sects living together, and there's absolutely no difference between them. And I think this is what makes Damascus so special, actually, as well, plus all the history that goes into it.
Thank you for inviting us here to your wonderful country.
Thank you, Antonio, for coming. Thank you.
And you stay tuned, because we'll be back with more of the Soccer Academy from Old Damascus. Welcome back to the Soccer Academy.
believe it or not, there is another soccer academy in the world, and that is the Milo Soccer Academy, and we ran across it right here in Damascus. And with us is the president and organizer, Mr. Tarek. Mr. Tarek, thanks for being with us.
You're welcome.
So tell us a little bit about the Milo Soccer Academy.
Milo Soccer Academy started with the idea of campings. We did about four campings in 4 years, and after we had this idea to look after the best junior player, which we choose through very professional coaches. Mm-hmm. And these people, we are taking care of them in this academy after we had the agreement, sponsorship of Milo, and we call this academy Milo Junior Soccer Academy.
Well, Coach, I want to congratulate you and the Smart Sport Company, as well as Milo Soccer Academies, for allowing us to join you here in Damascus.
You're welcome anytime, and we are happy to see you here in Syria.
Thank you, and maybe, I don't know if you'll allow me, but maybe they'll let me play with them a little bit.
Okay,
what do you think?
You can have your chance, and I hope you win.
I hope so.
You're
Coach
welcome.
Tarek, thank
welcome.
You.
Welcome.
Thank you very much.
Nice to see you again in Damascus.
Good
in Syria.
To see you.
You're welcome.
Inside of a restaurant in the city of Sidnaya, and I'm with the Honorary Consul General of Syria in Detroit, Dr. Naji Arwashan. Dr. Naji, thank you very much for having us here.
Thank you for coming to Syria, and it's my pleasure to have you here and to be taping and filming this about Syria. And
well,
welcome
to
Sidnaya.
I mean, thank you.
This restaurant is one of the very first restaurants here in this area in Sidnaya. Sidnaya is a small village outside Damascus, in the suburb of Damascus.
From a cultural perspective, this is really a great place to visit. I mean, when we look at it from outside, we say, well, I don't know, you know, going to Syria, it might be a little bit this, a little bit that. But this place is amazing, and the people have enormous hospitality. And you, in your role as a diplomat, as the Honorary Consul General in Detroit in the United States, what do you have to say in terms of a cultural invitation to our viewers?
Well, I am, in a sense, I am biased, but you are the true witness. I mean, you are here to see by yourself, come to Syria and see by yourself how wonderful Syria. If I tell you Syria is a wonderful country, I am biased, but you see by yourself.
Absolutely.
How nice, how safe, how hospitable the people, the food, the culture, the tourism. I mean, and the history, I mean. You have to mention here, we are talking about Christianity, but also you have in those villages, whether Sidnaya or Malula, you have mixed, the population is mixed, Muslims and Christians living together.
Islam and Christianity.
Absolutely, it's just a fact, I mean, you witness it by yourself.
It's amazing, here. People living in peace and harmony. And Dr. Naji, I wanted to thank you again for this invitation. Because of you, we're here in the great country of Syria, and thank you again for
being our host.
Welcome to Busra. Behind me are the ancient ruins of a Roman amphitheater. You're going to be absolutely amazed. I cannot believe how big this place is. I'm in the main corridor of the castle that connects us to the amphitheater. So stay with me, because we're going to see a lot more. The time of reckoning is finally here. Holy mackerel, look at this place. This amphitheater was built entirely by Roman laborers. It holds up to 15,000 people. Oh man, I had to use these ancient statues as practice cones. And guess what else I found? An ancient soccer ball, believe it or not. Well, you know what? Let's do some practice on it. All right, when we're passing the ball, remember that our target foot is always pointing toward the target. And our passing foot is coming all the way through, locked out at a 90 degree angle. Okay, pushing through the ball, and don't be afraid to exaggerate. Also, when we're shooting, target foot always pointing toward the goal, and here we go. Here we go. Laces, laces, strike through, strike through, strike that ball, baby. That's about all I can take with this ball. thanks for joining us here on the Soccer Academy from the great country of Syria in the Middle East. And if you want to know more about the Soccer Academy, log on to socceracademy.tv. That's socceracademy.tv. Soccer is always a kick in the grass.